that we used to pass by.
One of the best versions right there of Tim Hardin's great song, If I Were a Carpenter, and Walk Away Renee. I feel the Four Tops version better than the original from the Left Bank. 1970 brought the end to the Holland Dozier Holland era.
I was glad for them, but we were sad for us over the company. Cause we depended upon them so much that hardly anybody else was doing really any producing on us. And if they did, they were like they were trying to copy Holland Dozier Holland, which was, nobody could do that. So it was, we kind of lost there for a moment. But we hobnobbed around, and Frank Wilson come up with a couple of things that turned out to be really great. Stillwater's album and All in the Game we did off that album. And, but it was never quite the same once they left.
Right. And in 72, you left Motown, and
fortunate enough, went over there at
ABC.
ABC, and ran into Brian Potter, Dave Lambert, and produced by Steve Barry, Ain't No Woman to Keep Her the Castle.
You have to imagine how tough it was to leave an institution like the Sound of Young America, Motown Records, after a decade, and move on to another label with the chances of maybe not even getting another hit. Well, in 1973... they scored with Ain't No Woman Like the One I Got.
Ain't no woman like the one I've got. Ain't no woman like the one I've got. Ain't no woman like the one I've got.
Every day the sun.
Return with tonight's focus on the Four Tops after these words. I'm Gary Beck, and tonight's focus on the Four Tops continues.
What's your all-time favorite of all the ones we've talked about?
I'll tell you, to be honest, Baby, I Need Your Love.
Yeah.
I have to be very honest with you.
Yeah, I could tell in your voice because of the way you remember everything on that playback. You know, it was just coming out.
Even now.
Yeah.
And in fact, when you called, I was napping, but I was listening to my Showtime tape, the tape that was on last week.
Uh-huh.
And I just heard that song, and then my daughter was just, talking about it.
That's great.
Yeah, it's really something.
Then Ain't No Woman Like the One I've Got, it was still kind of...
Then we had to kind of, record-wise, we went into a low.
Yeah.
And we just couldn't get things going.
Were you playing Vegas and clubs? And?
Oh, yeah, we were always playing. We were always working. We were playing Vegas. We'd go across the waters on little tours. We were working all the time. Then we went to Polygram after that. which is Casablanca Polygram, mm-hmm. and we had When She Was My Girl.
Boy, 1981.
When I heard that come out, that was a good wake up call.
You guys are back.
You guys are back. Home again.
Yeah.
Back in the saddle.
That's right.
She used to be everything to me when she was my girl.
When She Was My Girl, 1981, they were back. Then came the idea for the most successful reunion show of all time on national television, the 25th anniversary Motown reunion.
We were over in Europe, and we were talking with Marvin Gaye. Had just had this hit, and he was ready to come back home. So him and I and Obie and Harvey Fuqua and a couple other people was talking about, they said, man, you know, it's really time for something really great to happen with Motown. Maybe all of us should get together and do some big summer tours like Woodstock or something. Mm-hmm. You know, I said, wow, that would be great. Boom, boom, boom. And we talked about it, even went down to how we would have merchandised the product and everything. So I said, Harvey, if you get back, tell Barry something about it. You know, boom.
A reunion or something.
Yeah, something. Well, 3 months later, I get this call. Boop. Hey, would y'all like to be, y'all like to come to the Motown 25 reunion? I say, oh, that would be superb. So during that time, it was about 3 months to go before we was to come. We was trying to figure out how to get out of this contract. Because we said, it sure would be nice if we could walk him in, get out of the contract.
Get back in the stable.
And go back home with
Jerry. Yeah, yeah.
So everybody said, well, you think he'd like us? So I said, well, I'm sure. Because he always has been our friend. We still talk to him. So somehow or another we did. They let us out and we got out. About 2 weeks before we went to record the Motown 25. And sure enough, the first person we saw when we walked in rehearsal was Berry Gordy. So we started waving and talking and cracking our usual jokes. And he was falling out on the floor. He said, man, you guys haven't changed. He said, plus, I've been watching you. I've been listening at you. So you sound better than you ever sound. So you guys even look kind of good. He said, tell you what, how would you like to come home? We looked at each other and said, phew. I was wondering who was going to pop the question. So you did it again, man. Yes. And we were back home again.
Great. And, of course, you know, anybody who ever watched the night that it was on, mm-hmm. won't ever forget the 25 anniversary.
God, no, I never will.
Yeah. And, I mean, there's video cassettes of that now.
Yeah. In fact, I really wish they could have taped a week of rehearsal. Mm-hmm. The fun that we had at rehearsal was like a week of picnic, you know? And what was really great about it, there was this one time, you know, even, all the stars, as big as they had gotten, all the men dressed in one big, like, locker room for the football team
or something,
which was great because everybody just hung down in there and we would crack our jokes and throw stuff around. I mean, that was one super week. Mm-hmm. And believe it or not, as good as that show was, and it was to me one of the better shows I've seen, not because I was on it, boy, if I could have had a camera for some footage in the dressing room.
Classic.
I mean, really classic. Clean classic, but
yeah.
Classic.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Baby, I need
That does it for tonight's focus on the Four Tops, one of the greatest groups to ever come out of America. My thanks to Duke Fakir of the Four Tops, Barry Gordy of Motown Records, and as always, Tony Sisti for the great inspiration. I'm Gary Beck on Focus.